I remember being in one of my first early classes in my first year of medical school, and they had taught us about genomic medicine. I came out of lecture and I called my mom, and my mom's a doctor, and I go, "Mom, this is the future of medicine." But the truth is that I've had that feeling again and again and again throughout my time at Penn. One of the reasons people come to Penn is the tremendous amount of resources available. This is where major breakthroughs are happening, and I get to be a part of that. I do want to be a clinical practicing physician, but I also want to make a difference on a bigger scale. And Penn shows me a million different ways I can do that.
One of the most enduring legacies of this campaign will be the tremendous investments in Penn Medicine. Penn Medicine is now literally one of a handful of premier academic medical centers in the United States, and it's a tremendous image builder and reputation builder for the University of Pennsylvania, and it's an incredibly important asset for medical discovery, medical research that is going to change people's lives internationally.
I have had the most amazing mentorship here. My mentor, Dr. Kovarik, she has dedicated so much of her time to helping me sort of figure out where I might want to go with my career. I have a passion for global health, and when I went to meet with her, she told me about her work and told me about telemedicine, which is essentially using information and communication technologies to bring providers and patients together when they're not physically together.
There's been no other point in time where technology has spread throughout the world like cell phones have in the last 5 years.
I can communicate and see a case from a resident in Botswana on my phone. This is one of the most exciting developments in medicine.
We've never seen this type of progress, and Penn is allowing us to capitalize on that technology and bring medicine to people globally.
From being on my surgery rotation and seeing the surgeon use the Da Vinci robot to control his case from across the room, to learning about gene therapy to cure blindness, to personally sitting in Dr. Kovarik's office and looking at and diagnosing a case from Africa while sitting in Philadelphia. This, I think, is the future of medicine, and I get to be a part of it because I'm at Penn.